Today we want to look back at the book of Genesis, and the rest of the week we'll be looking from the book of Genesis, but today I want to read from chapter 1, verse 27. So God created man in his own image. In the image of God created he him. Male and female created he them. We know that God created man and then put man to sleep and performed the first surgery while man was under, we would call, anesthesia. Like today, doctors put you to sleep and surgery is performed. Well, God did the same thing when he performed surgery on Adam. And from Adam's side, he took bone, rib, and flesh and created a woman. But what I wanted to use this for today is because of the situations that's going on in our land today. We are in a serious, serious time in this nation because we have forsaken God and the church has allowed Satan to come in and take over. And of course, he's in control of all nations to a point. But the church, the weakened church, and what happens when the church fails to be salt and light, then Satan begins to get stronger and stronger. And God now is removing his protection. And we see that God is allowing this nation to destroy itself. We look at the transgender issue. Now let me say this. There's no such thing as a transgender. God created man and woman. He created male and female. That's what he did. That's what we are. If there is a problem with you and Satan has twisted your thinking, and that's what it is. Satan gets in the mind of people and he twists their minds and they become confused, and God's not the author of confusion. We know that. But the problem that we have today is that Washington, whom we look to as the leader of this nation, is there contributing to the confusion. When the president sends out an order for the schools to go with his agenda of letting any person use any bathroom they feel like they should use that day. If they feel like they're a woman today, they use the girls. They feel like they're a man, they use the man's. And all he's doing is contributing to the confusion because he's been controlled by Satan. Now, if you have a problem with your gender, let me tell you how to settle that. It's very clear because God's already settled it. First thing you need to do is look at your body. Your body will tell you whether or not you are a man or woman. That's all you have to do, and I hope you have enough sense to look at your body. If you still have a problem with that, then I want you to go down to the hospital and take a blood test and let them do a DNA. And let them check you to see if you have XX chromosomes or XY chromosomes. And when that comes back, that will let you know if you are a male or female. So that should settle that. And listen to me, there is no such thing as transgender, transferring from one male to a female or female to a male. Bruce Jenner has just come out last week, and now he's decided he thinks he'd rather be a man, so he's decided he probably will transition back to a man. See, because he's so confused, he's caught up in this confusion that he don't know what's going on in his life, and he's living miserable. That's the way these folks live. And let me say this to you today, folks. If you're having a problem with this, it's Satan twisting your mind. And we know that you are, if you were born a man, you will die a man. If you were born a woman, you will die a woman. Bruce Jenner, I don't care how you feel. I don't care what kind of clothes you wear. I don't care which bathroom you use. I don't care how you do your makeup. You, sir, are a man. You was born a man. You will always be a man. Get that settled. And folks, let's pray for those that Satan has twisted their minds. Now, I know my time's gone over today from what I usually do, but thank you for listening. God bless.